from childhood I was compelled to concentrate attention upon myself. This caused me much suffering but, to my present view, it was a blessing in disguise for it has taught me to appreciate the inestimable value of introspection in the preservation of life, as well as a means of achievement. The pressure of occupation and the incessant stream of impressions pouring into our consciousness through all the gateways of knowledge make modern existence hazardous in many ways. Most persons are so absorbed in the contemplation of the outside world that they are wholly oblivious to what is passing on within themselves. Progressive development of man is vitally dependent on invention. It is the most important product of his creative brain. Its ultimate purpose is the complete mastery of mind over the material world, the harnessing of the forces of nature to human needs. This is the difficult task of the inventor, who is often misunderstood and unrewarded. But he finds ample compensation in the pleasing exercises of his powers and in the knowledge of being one of that exceptionally privileged class without whom the race would have long ago perished in the bitter struggle against pitiless elements.
These coils are my life.
Take our electrified world for granted. Energy that powers our needs is as close as the nearest outlet.
When you think of electricity, you think of Edison. When you think of radio, you think of Marconi. But there is one electrical genius who is nearly forgotten. A man who dreamed of giving the world an unlimited supply of energy.
When I was a child, I discovered to my delight that I could visualize anything I imagined. I could see and understand the inner workings of everything. The molecular interactions. I could see energy in the air. I needed no diagrams, no models. I knew with this ability I could create great and wondrous inventions, devices to solve all the world's problems.
All. Hunger, war, everything. Simply by making energy and communications readily available to everyone. I could do this. You know, I always believed that I have been led to evolve beyond my species. I am the next step of mankind.
His name was Nikola Tesla.
Today, our world is ablaze, thanks to Tesla's AC technology, for the power to change night into day. Thank Nikola Tesla.
He was a true American hero.
I believe that he was the most important inventor in human history.
Прошлое ведь вышло 7 десятилетия от 10 смерти. А живот и дело ovog hrvatsko-američkog znanstvenika svojom genijalnošću i misterioznošću nisu nas prestala uzbuđivati i inspiriraju na nova proučavanja i otkrivanja. Još od djetinjstva Tesla imao viziju usmjeravanja električne energije koja će kao munja na velike udaljenosti putovati bez dalekovoda. To je bio njegov svjetski sustav, odnosno distribucija energije, kao i informacija, primjerice zvuka i slike, mrežom prijenosnih tornjeva.
No subject to which I have ever devoted myself has called for such concentration of mind and strained to so dangerous a degree the finest fibers of my brain as the system of which the magnifying transmitter is the foundation. I put all the intensity and vigor of youth in the development of the rotating field discoveries. But those early labors were of a different character. Although strenuous in the extreme, they did not involve that keen and exhausting discernment which had to be exercised in attacking the many puzzling problems of the wireless.
Though widely ridiculed for his claim, Tesla may have been the first to detect radio waves from space. As a symphony of vibrations and waves. Following his uncanny intuition, he soon discovered that Tesla coils would transmit and receive powerful radio signals when they were tuned to resonate at the same frequency. Tuning is the key to all radio and television transmission.
Nikolu Teslu je nemoguće objasniti okviru zadanog znanja. I baš je to najljepše kod njega. Tesla je bez sumnje bio izniman genij za kakve gotovo da i nismo spremni priznati da postoji. Dobro je poznavao znanstvene teorije svojeg vremena, ali nije im dopustio da ga zaustavi. Umjesto toga je polagao formalne temelje, da, temelje, prema transcendentnom prostoru u kojem nema granica prema znanosti, umjetnosti i duhovnosti. Upravo tako su radili svi pravi geniji. Prisjetimo se primjerice Pitagore s grčkog otoka Samosa ili Leonarda iz Firenze. Tesla se rodio u Hrvatskoj, u Lici, pokraj planine Velebita, na pola puta između Grčke i Toskane. Tjeraju li u tom kraju sama njedra majke zemlje čovjeka da nastoji postići nešto na izgled nemoguće?
The progressive development of man is vitally dependent on invention. Its ultimate purpose is the complete mastery of mind over the material world, the harnessing of the forces of nature to human needs. Nikola Tesla, 1919.
Kada bismo danas pokušali izgovoriti ime Nikole Tesle, svaki puta kada upotrijebimo neki električni uređaj, sa čijim nastankom i funkcioniranjem on ima veze, bio bi nam potreban gotovo čitavi dan. Svoje je tehničke inovacije proizvodio tolikom brzinom da brojne izume nije uspio ni patentirati. A i one koje je patentirao, neki su bili toliko ispred svog vremena da mnogima ni dan danas ne možemo zamisliti praktičnu primjenu.
Tesla developed a system of AC generators that alternated electric current between negative and positive poles. This simple illustration became the patent for the induction motor, which would go on to be the standard electric motor for the world. It's used for everything, from tools and appliances, to hybrid cars, to industrial plants.
Teslin sustav izmjenične struje omogućio je motornu industrializaciju. Neki pisci tvrde da je Tesla izumio 20. stoljeće, što i nije puko pretjerivanje. Bez Teslinih se izuma elektricitet ne bi mogao prenositi na veće udaljenosti, a bez njegova postojanja odvojene se jedinice ne bi mogle povezati u cjeloviti energetski sustav.
It was Nikola Tesla who captured the power of Niagara Falls with his alternating current system and made it possible to transmit electricity to all of America and the world. It was Tesla who patented the technology for wireless communications that is used in all radio and television broadcasting. His incredible legacy can be seen in everything from remote control to neon and fluorescent lighting, X-rays, guided missiles, and even the Strategic Defense Initiative.
Machines, remote control, and green power. All from the fertile mind of the genius who electrified the world.
mind is certainly at a crossroads for the future. We need a mature decision. Tesla is thinking about developing skills of telematics and its application to automatic mechanisms, flying machines, cars, ships, submarines, and various types of weapons. In 1935, while working on a device that is believed to prevent wars, he said, like other inventors, I believed at one time that war could be stopped by making it more destructive, but I found that I was mistaken. I underestimated man's combative instinct. We cannot end it by disarming the strong. War can be stopped, not by making the strong weak, but by making every nation weaker strong, able to defend itself. Man, like the universe, is a machine. I actually constructed robots. Today the robot is an accepted fact. Man, in the large, is a massaged on by a force. Hence the general laws governing movement in the realm of mechanics are applicable to humanity.
Teslin stav prema oružju naoko je bio proturječan, no ipak na neki način razumljiv. Kao da je Tesla predvidio ono što se sada događa u vezi s razvojem oružja. Razvili smo megalomanske sustave samo zato da što prije uvidimo potrebu sprječavanja prijeteće katastrofe i uvjeta koji bi naš planet mogli pretvoriti u pakao.
In 1924, there was a news report that while at Colorado Springs, Tesla had invented a death ray machine that shot bolts of lightning. The inventor was strangely quiet on the topic. Meanwhile, a new scientific star, Albert Einstein, had captured the world's attention with his theory of relativity. Tesla continuously attacked the validity of Einstein's work.
Scientists today wander through equation after equation that have no relation to reality. If we were to release the energy of atoms, instead of a blessing, it might bring disaster to mankind.
But no one took him seriously. Rejected by traditional science, Tesla's interests again turned to the esoteric. Though nearly a recluse, he would occasionally attend dinner parties at the home of the German poet and mystic George Sylvester Viereck. And he always intrigued the guests. Tesla wrote a strange poem called Fragments of Olympian Gossip and dedicated it to Viereck.
While listening on my cosmic phone, I caught words from Olympus blown. The latest tells of a cosmic gun. To be pelted is very poor fun.
The meaning of the poem would soon be explained. Thomas Edison, America's best-known inventor, died in 1931. That same year, Tesla came back to life. His friends threw him a 75th birthday celebration. Time magazine put his picture on the cover. Letters of admiration poured in from scientists around the world. Basking in the attention, Tesla announced at a press conference that he had discovered a completely new source of power.
The idea when it first burst upon me, was a tremendous shock. And let me say that it has nothing to do with releasing so-called atomic energy.
When the Nazis rose to power in Germany, Tesla decided that the time was right to reveal his new source of power.
Nikola Tesla, electrical wizard and radio pioneer, announced that he was working on a machine to create a powerful electrical death beam, which could wipe out armies in a flash and destroy huge fleets of ships or planes.
Tesla's death beam stirred the public's imagination when it was featured in a Superman cartoon, The Electro-Euthanasia Ray. But the idea was more than science fiction.
Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound, the infant of Krypton is now the Man of Steel, Superman! To best be in a position to use his amazing powers in a never-ending battle for truth and justice, Superman has assumed the disguise of Clark Kent, mild-mannered reporter for a great metropolitan newspaper.
Very widely misunderstood, it may have been one of the reasons why he didn't receive some of the respect by the scientific community he may have well deserved. I think today a lot of people think of a death ray as a phaser or some esoteric type device you might see in a science fiction movie.
Tesla's claims terrify the public, but fascinate Hollywood. He is parodied in Superman cartoons as a mad scientist terrorizing New York with an electrothanasia death ray and an army of remote-controlled robots.
Tesla's death ray was actually a particle beam weapon. The basic concept is that you take a particle, a micro projectile it's called, and through the use of high voltage, you accelerate it to great velocities.
The newspaper Liberty Nikola Tesla in 1935 said,
"Svako sredstvo koje se koristi za odbranu može da služi i agresivnim namjerama. To obezvrijeđuje dobre namjere za ostvarenje mira. Ja sam, međutim, imao sreće da razvijem nove ideje kako da usavršim sredstva koja bi poslužila prvenstveno za odbranu. Ako budu prihvaćena, to će potpuno izmijeniti odnose između naroda. Time bi svaka zemlja, velika ili mala, postala neprebojna za neprijateljske vojske, avione ili druga sredstva napada. Moj izum zahtijeva izgradnju velikog generatora, no kada bude uspostavljen, biti će u stanju uništiti sve, od neprijateljske vojske do ratnih strojeva, u krugu od 400 km. On bi, da tako kažem, predstavljao snažan zid i nepremostivu prepreku pred bilo kakvim oblikom agresije. Moj aparat projecira čestice koje mogu biti relativno velike ili mikroskopskih dimenzija i omogućuje da se na mali prostor i na veliku razdaljinu prenese bilijune puta više energije nego što je moguće sa zracima bilo koje vrste."
If we want to avert an impending calamity and a state of things which may transform this globe into an inferno, we should push the development of flying machines and wireless transmission of energy without an instant's delay and with all the power and resources of the nation.
A century ago, Tesla saw the future of fossil fuels.
"If we use fuel to get our power, we are living on our capital and exhausting it rapidly. This method is barbarous and wantonly wasteful, and will have to be stopped in the interest of coming generations."
Tesla was disturbed by the rate at which society was burning up non-renewable fuels. Coal, oil was just coming in then. And he foresaw a time that you would need to go to some other source of power.
Tesla anticipated the development of what we now call renewable energy, that some of his ideas were a century ahead of his time. In fact, more than 100 years ago, Tesla was already green. In 1901, he patented an apparatus for the utilization of radiant energy. The patent refers to the sun, as well as other sources of radiant energy, like cosmic rays.
Nikola Tesla was one of the first people to realize that we have an almost endless supply of energy coming in from space, from our own sun.
Tesla also championed geothermal power.
Scientific electrical engineering. Electric power can drive the world's machinery without the need of coal, oil, or gas. Although perhaps humanity is not yet sufficiently advanced to be willingly led by the inventor's keen, searching sense. Perhaps it is better in this present world of ours that a revolutionary idea be hampered in its adolescence. All that was great in the past was ridiculed, condemned, combated, suppressed, only to emerge all the more triumphantly from the struggle. Our duty is to lay the foundation for those who are to come and to point the way. Yes, humanity will advance with giant strides. We are whirling through endless space with an inconceivable speed. All around, everything is spinning. Everything is moving. Everywhere, there is energy.
Nikola Tesla smatrao da će doći vrijeme kad će ga ljudi bolje razumjeti i tako svijetu dati čak i važnije izume neusporedivo s bilo čime što je prethodno stvorio. U mislima je vidio oscilirajuća električna polja oko Zemlje i smišljao leteće uređaje s antenama koje crpe energiju tih polja, pa velikom brzinom nečudno lete s kontinenta na kontinent. Danas bi ih zamijenili sa letećim tanjurima. Tesla piše 1919. godine. Još sam 1898. predstavnicima velikog industrijskog koncerna predložio izgradnju i javno izlaganje automobilnog vozila koje bi samo obavljalo različite operacije što bi podrazumijevalo i sposobnost sličnu prosuđivanju. Ali u to su vrijeme moj prijedlog ocijenili nevjerojatnim, pa od njega nije bilo ništa.
My project was retarded by laws of nature. The world was not prepared for it. It was too far ahead of time. But the same laws will prevail in the end and make it a triumphal success.
This man has a vision to create the best electric cars ever seen and consign gasoline to history.
This is something truly revolutionary.
He wants to build his unprecedented Tesla car in a futuristic new factory.
Our goal is to create an electric car that is the best car in the world and show that that's what an electric car can be.
Tesla's goal is to kill off the combustion engine and prove the electric car has finally come of age. the motor unit is also developed in-house. It's essentially an AC induction motor, a concept invented by 19th century scientist and Tesla Motors namesake, Nikola Tesla.
One cutting-edge car maker is paying homage to Tesla's green foresight by adopting his name. Tesla Motors in San Carlos, California, makes a battery-driven Tesla Roadster that goes from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 3.9 seconds. Using a version of Tesla's AC induction motor, it travels more than 200 miles without a drop of gas.
Rodio se u noći između 9. i 10. srpnja 1856. godine, dok su sjevale munje i tutinjala grmljavina. Babica koja je pomagala majci pri porodu našalila se. Ovo dijete će biti dijete Oluje. Na to je majka odgovorila. Ne, ono će biti dijete svjetlosti. Naravno, da nije ni mogla zamisliti koliko će biti istine u tim njenim spontano izgovorenim riječima. Nikola je rođen u selu Smiljani na zemljopisnom prostoru Like u ondašnjoj carjevini Austrije i kraljevini Ugarske, te trojedinoj kraljevini Dalmacije, Hrvatske i Slavonije, odnosno buduće Jugoslavije, a današnje Republike Hrvatske. Odrastao je i školovao se u Lici, prekrasnom gorskom krajoliku, čiji su ponos planina Velebit i svjetski čuveni nacionalni park Plitvička jezera. Blagoslovljeni krajolik obdaren izuzetnim prirodnim ljepotama i raznolikošću. Iznad njegova rodnog sela. Družio se sa ovcama, patkama, kokošima, golubovima. Volio je konje. Odrastao je u krajoliku, gdje se priroda i duh susreću u radosti stvaranja. Iskonska priroda ga je oduvijek oduševljavana, htio ju je bolje upoznati.
Welcome to a fairy tale world of secrets and transformations, which, like Sleeping Beauty, lay undisturbed for centuries. This is Plitvice, land of the falling lakes.
Thank you.
Ilića, koji prvo uči od prirode, u Lici, u Hrvatskoj, obdarenoj izuzetnim i očuvanim prirodnim ljepotama. U autobiografiji Tesla je lijepo pisao kako se u mladosti družio s velikom učiteljicom prirodom, koja ga je već u ranom djetinjstvu povela na izumiteljski put. Kontakt s prirodom, iznad svega, je stapanje s drugim bićima, čak i kad su ta bića posve drugačija, možda čak i došljaci iz drugih svijetova. U povijesti prirodnih znanosti, posebice fizike, velika su inventivna otkrića obično ostvarili umovi koji su s jedne strane divili se apstraktnoj ljepoti matematike, ali su također zaljubljeno divili se bogatoj slici svijeta. Tesli pripadaju goleme zasluge za utemeljenje globalnog ekonomskog sustava. Veliki i tehnički složeni sustavi uklanjaju jednostavnu izvornu ljudsku osjećajnost, što je nužan temelj za suosjećajni uvid i etički stav.
The scientific man does not aim at an immediate result. He does not expect that his advanced ideas will be readily taken up. His work is like that of the planter for the future. His duty is to lay the foundation for those who are to come and point the way. The day when we shall know exactly what electricity is will chronicle an event probably greater, more important than any other recorded in the history of the human race. Then it will be a mere question of time when men will succeed in attaching their machinery to the very real work of nature. See the excitement coming.
The greatest goodwill comes from technical improvements tending to unification and harmony, and my wireless transmitter is preeminently such. By its means, the human voice and likeness will be reproduced everywhere in factories driven thousands of miles from waterfalls furnishing the power. Aerial machines will be propelled around the earth without a stop, and the sun's energy controlled to create lakes and rivers for motive purposes and transformation of arid deserts into fertile land.
U svojim najstvaralačkijim godinama Tesla je razmatrao mogućnost korištenja električnih oscilacija u ionosferi za rasvjetljavanje cijele atmosfere oko zemaljske kugle, kako na Zemlji više ne bi bilo noći i ljudi bi mogli stvarati 24 sata na dan. To je doista smatrao darom čovječanstvu. Međutim, ubrzo je u svojim člancima počeo sve više zagovarati neizvještačen, prirodan, zdrav život. Navedeni primjer svjedoči da je svaki slučaj megalomanije problematičan jer poništava prirodne procese. Tesla je danas besmrtan. Njegova domovina, ili ako baš hoćete domovine, i danas su na raskrižju. Svijet ni danas nije idilično mjesto. Teslin ne zamisli u mnogome se koriste na dobrobit čovječanstva, ali i u ratne svrhe. Tesla nije služio određenoj zemlji. Njega je zanimala sudbina čovječanstva.
It is essential to the peaceful existence of humanity as a whole that one common conception should prevail. Religious dogmas are no longer accepted in their orthodox meaning, but every individual clings to faith in a supreme power of some kind. We all must have an ideal to govern our conduct and ensure contentment, but it is immaterial whether it be one of creed, art, science or anything else.
Tesla piše, dar mentalne energije dolazi od Boga, vrhunskoga bića, i ako mi koncentriramo naše misli o toj istini, postajemo skladni sa ovom velikom moći. Majka me je učila da tražim istinu u Bibliji. Na zemlji ima puno palih anđela. Po sebe sam stvorio ono što sam htio, promišljeni duhovni stroj. Moj mozak je samo prijemnik. U svemiru postoji jezgra iz koje dobivamo znanje, snagu i inspiraciju. Nisam prodro u tajne te jezgre, ali znam da ona postoji. U svakom kutku svemira postoje energije života. Jedna od njih je i besmrtnost, čije je porijeklo izvan čovjeka i čeka ga. Svemir je duhovan. Mi imamo dva oka, zemaljsko i duhovno. Poželjno je da ona prerastu u jedno oko. Tesla je bio uvjeren da sve u svemiru od galaksije do elektrona ima svijest, da je kozmos jedan razumni živi organizam. Za njega je svemir integralni organizam koji se sastoji od više dijelova koji su slični, ali se razlikuju po različitoj frekvenciji i vibracija. Svaki dio je paralelni svijet. Ulazeći u rezonancu sa frekvencijom nekog drugog svijeta, mi kao da otvaramo prozor u taj paralelni svijet. Tako se može putovati kozmosom. Ovo zvuči fantastično i nama u 21. stoljeću. A možemo li zamisliti kako su to doživljavali Teslini suvremenici konce 19. i početkom 20. stoljeća? No, Tesla je bio samo jedan od nas. Čovjek koji je osvijetlio našu tamu i koji nas i nakon svoje smrti ponovo i ponovo dovodi do vječnog pitanja. Tko smo? Što smo, otkuda smo, zašto smo tu, koja je naša misija i koje su naše mogućnosti.